the last 1 hour 20 minutes we are learning EPS. Actually we didn't learn many things, just earnings by number of shares. Earnings means it has to be PAT minus preference dividend minus dividend distribution tax on preference dividend. Don't think so much of time spent, lot of discussion made. I would have taken time, but actually it is only very simple thing. PAT minus preference dividend minus dividend distribution tax on preference dividend. Then we have denominator, number of share. What number? Weighted average. Weighted average is what, sir? Number into weights. Which weight? Period weight, paid up value weight. Paid up value weight means amount paid divided by face value. Period weight means number of months outstanding by 12. Initially I told number of months means from the date of issue to the year ending date. But now it is not issue date, it is effective date to the year ending. What are effective dates we are discussing? And application of that effective date. Correct, Appa? So if there, it is amalgamation nature of purchase means date of amalgamation. Amalgamation nature of merger means first day of current reporting period. And bonus issue means? Bonus issue means first day of the previous reporting period. Correct, Appa? Respond. Now why is it that first day of previous reporting period, sir? Is what we like to discuss now. Shall we? Respond. Can I turn this page? Let me give you some numbers and explain the logic behind that. Again, please, sir, if you read the books, you know the principles, rules, no logics there. But try to understand here. 12-13, year 12-13, I report a profit of say 8 lakhs. How much?
8 lakhs.
The number of shares being 2 lakhs. Number of shares being 2 lakhs. What is EPS, friends? EPS is considered as a one of the tool for measurement of the performance. EPS is a tool for the measurement of performance of a company. Correct? Now 8 lakhs is the profit divided by 2 lakh number of shares. You are getting EPS of 4 rupees. Correct? Now in the next year, when is that you consider to be improving your performance if EPS is reduces? EPS increases. Only when EPS is increasing, your performance is increasing. If the EPS is reducing, performance is getting reduced. Could you appreciate that? Please respond. Okay, friends. If your profit is increasing, your performance is increasing now. But if your profit is increasing with additional resources, this year you employed 10 lakhs money, next year you are employing 20 lakhs money, and little increase in profit is not actually increase in performance. If you maintain same resource in the first year as well as second year, if you maintain same resources, when I say resources means assets employed there, capital employed in the business, respond pa. If you employ the same net asset in the company in the first year as well as in the
second year,
and even if you increase your profit by 1 rupee, it is called increase in performance. Correct, Appa? First year, second year, resources remaining same. Understood? But your profit is performance is increasing. Correct, Appa? You really feel that once the resources are same, no new money, no new asset comes into the business, but my profit is increased by 1 rupee now, then increase in performance. Correct, Appa? Respond. Now imagine this company have increased the profit by 3 lakhs. The company have in the year 13-14. Profit has become how much? 11 lakhs. Correct, Appa? Respond. Profit has become 11 lakhs. But the company also did one thing. Out of the huge reserves the company had, company gave bonus on 1st of 8, 2013. Which year? 13-14. Bonus 1:1. Bonus. How many shares?
Two lakh.
How many shares, ma? 2 lakh shares. Everybody respond. So now, how to compute the EPS of this year? Profit divided by, even though bonus issued on what date, pa? For that year it is considered 12 months. So thereby it is 2 lakhs into 12 by 12. Additional bonus also 2 lakhs into 12 by 12. 4 lakhs. 2.75. Are you all following?
Yes, sir.
Sir, what happens by issuing bonus shares? Number of shares?
Increases.
But is it increasing the resources of the company? Is it the same resource employed in the previous year, employed in the current year, or different resources?
Yes.
Same resources. Understood, Appa? Respond.
Yes, sir.
Last year also same assets liability. This year also same assets and liability. By issue of bonus, you are not getting any fresh cash.
Yes, sir.
No new assets. Correct, Appa? Same resources, but profit increased by? 3 lakhs. Increase in performance. Respond, pa. But my EPS showing as if my performance is decreased. My EPS is showing as if my performance is
decreased.
A person who doesn't see the profit, a person see only
EPS,
will feel that my performance have decreased. From 4 rupees EPS, your performance have decreased by 1 rupee 25 paise. Close to 25 to 30%, 32%, your performance have reduced. Understood, Appa? But actually my performance have
increased.
By around 35%, my performance have increased. And this showing as if my performance is reduced. Correct?
Yes,
then the standard says that, sir, whenever you issue, then in this year 13-14, you also adjust the EPS of previous year. You adjust the EPS of? How not? Take the profit of 8 lakhs and you tell the readers that 2 lakhs bonus issue made in the was also there in the previous year as shares. Whatever shares you issued in the was also there in the previous year as shares, because that resource was there in the previous year, pa. The resource used for bonus reserves, no, pa. That was there even in the previous year. So divide by that 2 lakhs plus 2 lakhs, how much, pa? 4 lakhs, and tell the readers that previous year EPS you should see as, don't compare 4 with the 2.75, you forget this 4 rupees and compare what, pa? 2 rupees with the 2.75. It's all logic, sir. Generally you will ignore the logic part at IPCC. I want you to learn the logic, sir, only at 5-11. But we are just striking time just to understand, get better clarity. Understood, Appa? So now, thereby one day, for bonus issue we take first day of previous reporting period. So whenever bonus shares are made, we are telling the readers that these shares were existing during this year full, as well as it was also there in the
previous
year full. Understood, whatever bonus shares issued in the current year was existing throughout the current year, as well as it was there in the
previous
year, throughout the previous year. Correct, Appa? So we are telling the readers, don't compare 4 rupees with 2.75 users. Please compare 2 with the 2.75. We can really see that our performance have increased, not declined. Correct, Appa? But to really show your performance, the bonus should be taken as existing throughout the current year, as well as existing throughout the previous, because through bonus issue you are not getting extra resources, cash, asset, nothing you are getting. Correct, Appa? Please respond, friends.
Yes, sir.
Everybody.
Yes, sir.
So thereby bonus issue means what you should do, forget all the logics also if you are not understanding. Ultimately what you should do now, you should adjust the EPS of
previous.
How to adjust the EPS of previous year? Previous year profits by previous year profit divided by, don't say current year wins, it is previous year wins plus bonus. Sir, anyway it is equal, no, sir. I can use it as current year wins, no, you can't tell, because suppose currently you also had fresh issue of shares. You also had rights issue of shares. That you can't consider in the
previous
year. Are you following? So you should be adjusting the EPS of previous year only by taking current year bonus. Respond, ba.
Yes,
so this is called adjusted basic EPS. Correct? So whenever you have bonus in a year, you will report 3 EPS.
Yes,
what are 3 EPS?
EPS?
Basic EPS of current year, adjusted EPS of previous year, diluted EPS. In fact, adjusted diluted EPS also, like that 4 EPS. Further, you should know what is diluted EPS, we will discuss later. Understood? So presently, we are understanding the reasoning behind the bonus issue. Whenever we have bonus issue, we should take the effective date as? First day of the previous reporting period. We should take the bonus issue as? First day of the previous reporting period. Correct? Because of that, what we should do? Whenever we have bonus, we adjust the EPS of? We adjust the EPS of? Previous year. We will be reporting current year EPS as well as we will report. After adjustment, we'll reverse the EPS. Correct? So we'll adjust the EPS. So we'll tell it is 8 lakhs divided by 4 lakhs. Whatever bonus share existed issued in the current year was also there in the previous year because it is out of reserves. The reserves was there in the current year, reserves was also there in the everybody. Please try to understand, friends.
Yes, sir.
Are you following?
Yes, sir.
The bonus issue means it is outstanding from the first day of. It is because the reserves used for that bonus was there in the current year as well as in the prior period.
Yes, sir.
Question number 5. Question number 5, sir. Aprom. Net profit for the year ending 31st March 2013, 18 lakhs. Net profit for the year ending 31st March 2014, 60 lakhs. Number of equity shares outstanding on 31st March 2013, 20 lakhs, rupees 20 lakhs, laba, the numbers. That is not rupees, it is numbers. Bonus issue on 1st September 2013, one for every one held. The bonus or date relevant or irrelevant? Because we will always take for 12 months only. This year also 12 months? Previous year also 12 months. Correct, apa? And find out EPS basic for? Both the years. Friends, listen, EPS of both the years now. Reporting date on 31st March 2013. When you make an annual report on 31st March 2013, basic EPS equal to 18 lakhs divided by 20 lakhs. 0.9. Friends, that time no bonus. This is the year in which I am reporting. 12-13 I am reporting. Correct, Appa? Respond. And the time I was not even knowing about bonus and all. Then when you come to the next year, reporting date, 31st March 2014. In this year only bonus happened. Respond. Which year? 13-14. In this year only bonus happened. On which date? 1st September. Even though it is 1st September and all, that is not relevant. Correct, Appa? Appo, I will take basic EPS equal to 60 lakhs divided by 20 plus 20. It is 40 lakhs equal to 1.50. And I will also report adjusted basic EPS of 12-13. In the year 13-14, I am reporting one more EPS. I am telling this you don't take. It is 18 lakhs by 40 lakhs. 0.45. Understood? In the previous year when I reported, I was not aware of the bonus. Now this is the reporting in the current year. I am reporting 2 EPS, current year EPS as well as previous year EPS. I will adjust the EPS. So when will you adjust EPS, friends? Whenever there is bonus. Whenever there is bonus, then you will adjust the EPS of previous year. Understood? Pakka? Friends, please listen. I told you this standard covers something called bonus element. Bonus element in rights issue. This bonus element is computed as fair value prior to rights divided by theoretical X right price. Theoretical X right price. Theoretical X right price. Hi. So theoretical X right price is what we understand as TERP. So bonus element equal to fair value prior to rights divided by theoretical X right price. Now fair value prior to rights is something to be given by the question. Theoretical X right price is something to be conveyed by the question that it is nothing but the exchange value between two knowledgeable willing parties at arm's length transaction. I think I have discussed in some other standards. So in many standards it's the same definition which will be continued. That it is the exchange value between two knowledgeable willing parties at arm's length transaction. So that has to be given in the question. Fair value of the share. Generally market price. I can tell market price is fair value. But then if there is no market, what is the price there? Then there should be some selling price now. That is what we call it as fair value. Everybody. Divided by theoretical X right price. Which means after rights, how much will be the expected value of the share? After the rights, what is the expected value of the share? That is what we call it as theoretical X right price. Not the actual market price. It is the theoretical X right price. Understood? Theory. So just expected price. So thereby fair value divided by theoretical X right price will give you what? Bonus element. For which they will give you what? Theoretical X right price we should find out. Which is equal to number of shares prior to rights into fair value per share, understood, plus number of right shares into issue price divided by number of shares prior to rights plus number of right shares. Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Fine. So imagine our Manikandan. See, Manikandan is assumed to be bachelor. He is having wealth of 50 lakhs. Present wealth of Manikandan is 50 lakhs. Now, the important event is happening in his life. Marriage. After that event, the wealth please stop talking, friends. Please don't think like a filthy mind. Think clean. Friends, please keep quiet. Okay. We understand his excitement. Okay. But only thing what we could not understand is why he is excited about Manikandan's marriage. Fine. Please listen, friends, please stop talking, don't disturb.
Yes, sir.
After the demand, the wealth, the total wealth came to 90 lakhs. What is that? I don't know. I won't explain. Sorry, I don't know. What is that? So 50 lakhs. Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Now, before that event, to share the wealth, there was only one person. After that event, to share the wealth, there are not 3-4 persons on Alba. 2%. So how they will share entirely, Manikandan will take all these things, we don't know. But theoretically, what is the wealth of one person?
45
lakhs. How did you compute that? Wealth before plus wealth received divided by total number of persons after that event. Everybody. Similarly, friends, before this event of rights, we are taking the wealth of the shareholders. We are taking the, what is that we are computing? Number of prior to rights. That company is having how many shares into fair value per share is the total wealth of shareholders before the rights. Before the event of rights, this is the wealth of the shareholders. Respond. Through this event called issue of rights, how much wealth is coming into the business? Number of right shares or number of shares issued into issue price. Please respond, friends. This is the actual money that is coming into the business. That is the wealth that is flowing into the business. Correct, Appa? So the existing wealth plus new wealth is the total wealth divided by total number of shares after that event. What is the total number of shares after that event? Number of shares prior to that event plus new shares. Number of shares prior to rights plus number of right shares. Could you appreciate that? So don't learn like that formula. It is only a common sense approach, friend. Here you apply that 45 lakhs in no time now.
Yes,
so that common sense only we are applying. What we had plus what we are getting divided by total number of person after that event sharing. Are you following? That should be the expected value of one person or one share. Correct? Please respond. But in market, not necessarily that should be the price. Market price may fluctuate based on the demand and supply. Are you following this? Theoretically, this should be the price. Everybody, so that is what we understand in theoretical exercise price. So instead give you, it is actually m into a plus n into b divided by m plus a, where m equal to what, a equal to what, n equal to what, b equal to what, like that will be defining. But simple common sense, what do you have? Number of shares into present price of the share is the wealth of the shareholders plus proceeds from rights. Present net worth plus proceeds from rights divided by total number of shares after rights is called theoretical exercise. This theory expected, this should be the price of the share after the rights. Please respond.
Yes, sir.
Bonus element equal to
fair value
prior to rights divided by theoretical exercise price. We'll give you what? Now I'll tell you the background of this concept. What is this bonus element, theoretical, we are understanding computation, what exactly is that? The standard says that when the shares are issued for cash, and that too if it is issued as a rights issue, then the standard says that in that rights, there is some hidden bonus. Through that rights, you are giving some bonus. So what is actually bonus share? Shares issued without consideration, free of cost. Correct, Appa? Respond. If I get cash and issue shares, is it bonus? But the standard says that in that some bonus is hidden. Are you following? That is what actually the bonus element in rights issue. Rights kulla some bonus is there. Are you following this? We call it as bonus element in rights issue. Understood? Why is like that standard is identifying, sir? Because if the shares are issued at a price lower than the fair value, sir, market light is getting sold at 90 rupees. But company is presently issuing the share only for 60. Why like that issuing at a lower price? Because it is issuing to the existing shareholders. It is issued into the? Because it is issuing to the existing shareholders, some loyalty was given to them. Respond. And thereby, instead of 90, we are giving at 60. Understood? Some concession you are offering. The concession is not less than face value, less than market price. Understood? But that concession, the standard say, is a bonus. Are you following? But that we can't express in number of shares. We will not express in will express as a fraction. Understood? That is what we call as bonus element equal to fair value prior to rights divided by theoretical ex-right price. Understood? Now once that bonus element is there, now whether all the rights issue will have bonus element, sir, never we have so far learned for the rights issue. We have seen in 3-4 questions, sir, never you discuss bonus element, because in those questions very clearly given rights never had any. So which means one thing is very clear, not necessary that all the rights should have. Whenever you have rights, there is bonus element we can't tell. So only if the rights is made at a price. Suppose the rights is made at a price equal to or more than, there is no bonus element. Are you following? So it is not all the problems has got bonus element. Only if the rights issue is made at a price less than fair value, then there is bonus element. Correct? Please respond. Okay, so question, definitely they will give fair value and all. Otherwise, for usual computation EPS, fair market price is irrelevant. Fair market price, something is given in the question. Now, definitely you should understand there is something called bonus element in rights issue. You should compute bonus element. For computing bonus element, first you can't compute this, you should find out theoretical ex-right price, existing number of shares into the present market price, is the present wealth plus proceeds from wealth. How to get that number of shares issued into issue price, total wealth, total number of shares is called theoretical ex-right price. Bonus element equal to fair value divided by theoretical ex-right price. Understood? Sorry, sir, but how do you use this bonus element? What way relevant to EPS computation? Now this bonus element will be used in calculation of VAMES. This is actually not going to affect the numerator. What is the numerator? Profit. Profit and nothing going to be affected. It is going to affect only VAMES. Correct? So because you say that bonus element is included in rights, no? Rights na I will take only from the issue date. Yes, sir. Yes. Respond. Bonus na I will take throughout the year. Correct? About total issue la, suppose rights issue was made on 1st July 2013. Yes, sir. First July. If it is only rights, no bonus na, entire shares outstanding for 9 months only. Yes, sir. But in that bonus is there na, then rights is there for 9 months, bonus is there for 12 months. At that point, that is what the argument of the standard. Understood? Thereby the standard wants to split between rights and bonus. If there is bonus in the contract of rights, and nothing is called, no word is given related to bonus. This standard only introducing new concept called bonus element in rights issue. Shall we proceed? So when you have bonus element, when will you have bonus element? When the issue price is less than, then VAMES will be computed like this. Opening number of shares into bonus element into number of months up to rights divided by 12. Opening number of shares into bonus element into number of months up to rights by 12 into plus total number of shares after rights. Total number of shares after rights. What is total number of shares, sir? Opening number of share plus right share is what we call it as total number of shares after rights into number of remaining months. What do you mean by remaining months? From the rights date to the year ending, remaining months by 12. This is how you'll be computing VAMES. If you have bonus element in rights issue, not only that, you should know one more thing, that you should also restate the EPS of previous year. You should restate the EPS of, so thereby you also compute, this is current year VAMES. Previous year VAMES, how to compute? Now, previous year number of shares into bonus element into 12 by 12. That's all. There is no right shares that will be considered. Previous year number of shares into bonus element into 12 by 12. We understand that bonus element was there throughout the year. Bonus concept was there. Rights was there only from 1st July onwards. That is from the date of write, sir. Respond. But bonus was there from the beginning. Understood? Not only beginning of current year, it was also there in the previous year. You should adjust the EPS of previous year. That we already told. Whenever you have bonus, it is not only in the current year, but also there in the previous year. That is the concept. Are you following? So we are actually discussing a concept called bonus element in. Can I take the previous page? Bonus element in rights issue. This bonus element in rights issue possible only when the issue prices less than the fair value. Only when the issue prices less than the fair value. Correct, appa? Sorry. Now, bonus element equal to how to compute it? Fair value, not face value. Fair value prior to rights, before the rights, divided by theoretical ex right price. What is theoretical? What is fair value, sir? Will be given or computed? Will be given. Definitely given. I can't compute it. Next. Theoretical ex right price. Simple common sense. What we have, what we got, divided by total number of percent. So what we have, how to find out? Number of shares prior to rights into fair value. Present wealth plus number of right shares into issue price divided by number of shares prior to rights plus number of rights. In other words, total number of shares after rights. In other words, total number of shares after rights. Everybody. Now, how to compute the VANs using this BE, sir? Using the bonus element. How to compute the VANs, sir? For current year VANs. Opening number of shares. Bonus is there right from beginning, sir. Into bonus element. Into number of months up to rights. Respond. Plus total number of shares after rights. Remaining months. Correct? You should not be asking, or you must have get the doubt, sir. Here you are multiplying bonus element, sir. Why here you are not multiplying bonus element, sir? Because the moment you take total number of shares after rights, so bonus is included there. We are not telling that suppose I am issuing 50,000 rights, and then it is 50,000 rights plus bonus. It is not like that. It is that 50,000 includes bonus. Are you following? So thereby the moment I add 50,000 to the opening number of share, that includes what? Bonus also. There is no need for one second multiply with bonus element. Understood? Bonus element to be multiplied only on opening number of shares. Understood? But what is the relationship between bonus element and opening number of shares? What is this formula application? I have conducted research for this itself, but these things I can explain you only when in final calls. Understood? So that I don't want to unnecessarily spend time. So this is simple application only presently. It is opening number of shares into bonus element into number of months up to rights by plus total number of shares after rights into remaining period by 12. Not only you should do that, you should also restate the EPS of. So it is previous year number of shares into bonus element into 12 by 12. Shall we proceed to the question? Pakka. Question number 6. Question number 6, friends, page number 45, given below information regarding the capital of a company. 40 lakhs equity shares at rupees 3.50, 140 lakhs. Presently, they are telling net worth, wealth is 140 lakhs. One share is having a value of 3 rupees 50 paise. 9 months later, the company had issued one share, four shares held and given rights. That is, this is what rights to existing shareholders at rupees 2.80. When the value is 3.50, the issue price is 2.80. Find out bonus element in rights issue and also current year weights. Please apply your mind, friends. Apply that issue information given in the question. Yes, answer.
1.042.
Friends, first I will compute theoretical x right price 40 lakhs into 3.5 plus 10 lakhs into 2.8 divided by 40 lakhs plus 10 lakhs. Are you following, friends? This is the wealth of the shareholders now, plus new proceeds divided by 40 lakhs plus 10 lakhs, right? So 3.36, right? Then bonus element equal to 3.50 divided by 3.36. 1.7. Everybody, now weights. Friends, please listen, friends. Opening number of shares, 40 lakhs. I want your attention here. Into 1.0417 into 9 months, 9 by 12. Correct, Abba? How you got 9 months? 9 months later only rights issue was made. So up to rights. Right? Next. Plus 50 lakhs. That is very good. Not 10 lakhs. It is 40 plus 10. 50 lakhs. Into 3 by 12. That's very nice. $43,75,000. Now listen, friends. Friends, please listen. Even though I write here 1.0417, you write 1.04 also, I don't mind. But when you use calculator, friends, please listen. You will miss. You will miss. When you use a calculator, it is always better to take the calculator like this. It is 40 lakhs into 3.5 by 3.36. You know that this 1.0417 is nothing but the fraction of this 3.5 divided by 3.36. So that way, to get the accuracy in answer, nothing wrong, you get 43,7500. It is correct only. But to get the more accuracy, you take like this 40 lakhs into 3.5 by 3.36. That is a bonus element, correct? So multiply like that, 40 lakhs into 3.5 divided by 3.36 into 9 by 12, correct? Plus 50 lakhs into 3 by 12, you get 43,75,000. There also it is 999 and like that it will come. Are you following this, everybody? So even though you write any 1.04, you round off to 3 decimals or 4 decimals. But when you apply using calculator, now better you use this fraction. You get more accurate answer. Correct? Respond. So this is how we are applying. So this is theoretical x right price, bonus element, Wayne's computation. Question number 7. Net profit for the year ending 31st March 2013. Before I forget, actually in this question, this is 1/4/2013. I forgot. One of our friends showed that correction. Net profit for the year ending 31st March 2013, 11 lakhs. Net profit for the year ending 31st March 2014, 15 lakhs. Number of shares prior to the rights issue, 5 lakhs. Rights issue rate, 1 for every 5. Fair value prior to rights, 21. Subscription price for rights issue, 15. Rights issue was made on 1/5/2013. Find out EPS basic for the year. 12/13 and 13/14. Find out EPS basic for the year. 12/13 and 13/14. Please apply your mind. First compute bonus element. I'm sorry. Theoretical exercise price. Then bonus element. Current year wins, previous year wins. These four computation you make, EPS can be easily computed. Over. Yeah. 2.09. So 2.10. That can be decimal. Once it is EPS, 2 decimals only. 2.10. Okay. Theoretical. X right price. Can you help me out? No. Oh. 5 lakhs into 21. 1 lakh into 15. You got rupees? 20. Friends, whatever you work out for the total number of shares, alternatively can be completed like this for one write. What are the terms of the write? 1 for 5. So 5 into 21 plus 1 into 15 divided by 5 plus 1. So you don't require even the calculator help also. 5 into 21, 105 plus 15, 120 by 620. Or alpha I can also work out like this, 5 into 21, 105 plus 15, 120 by 620. So what you work out for total number of shares, you can also even work out for a single write. Understood? Now, bonus element equal to 21 by 20, 05. Veins of 13, 14. Veins of 13, 14. 5 lakhs into 1.05 into, that's very good, 6 lakhs into 11 by 12. It's very good. Yeah. I don't have space. Can I turn this page? Okay. Veins adjusted for 12-13. 1.05 into 5. Now reporting date 31st March 2013. Basic EPS equal to 11 lakhs by 5 lakhs, 2.20. Reporting date 31st March 2014. Basic EPS equal to 15 lakhs divided by 5,93,750. 2.10. Correct? 5, 3. Adjusted basic EPS equal to 11 lakhs divided by So happy birthday to Venkatesh. Please give him a big clap. Happy birthday. It's already started. எப்போ பார்த்தாலும் ஆப்பிளா அப்படின்னா படுப்பாவீங்களே, இதெல்லாம் ரெக்கார்ட் ஆகுது. Can I turn this page? Friends, please stop talking. Dilution, diluted. It means, what is the layman's understanding mean dilution? Reducing the effect. Everybody? I don't know what and all you are visualizing. So the general plain meaning is reducing, reduction. Everybody? Okay. So the reduction effect is what we usually understand as dilution. And for reducing, you will use various components and all. Chips. Friends, please. We don't know how much time, but last 10 minutes, please listen, my friends. But it got changed, you don't know. Yes. Friends, please. And 1:45, sir, welcome. Please listen. Friends, please stop talking. Just introduction. Reduction. Basic EPS actually provides the present performance for the recently made performance is represented in the form of basic EPS. You have made this much profit. This is the number of share. Earnings of one share is this much. Like that, you are showing the present performance in the form of basic EPS. Now, what is this EPS going to convey to the readers? So, basic EPS will convey about this is my performance. Now, dilutive EPS is an information about the future reduction, possible reduction. The future possible reduction. Now, we are going to tell the readers that, see, don't go by this report alone. There is a possibility that in future, our EPS may reduce. That sort of information only we are going to present in the form of dilutive EPS, being so conservative. Respond. If our EPS is going to increase, we will not report.
Yes, sir.
If the EPS is going to reduce, understood, Abba? It's the general psychology that if we have some future fortunes, we won't tell. Even if we write the exam very well, this system culture will come right from very young age onwards. Even if we write very well, we won't tell others. Pass on, ale poru. Then we'll tell to friends. Then after that, when we get very good marks, na, just 98 only out of 100 I got. Like that, this is normal friend culture only. Friends, please listen. So generally, this conservative mind we will have, any future adversity will be immediately communicated. We always want everybody to get prepared for it. But if it is future fortunes, we won't tell. Understood? We want to really enjoy that particular fortune. So thereby we will keep it as a secret one. Correct? So similarly, if you are going to see some future increase in number of, I mean increase in EPS, don't report now. Don't tell the shareholders now. We'll tell later. But when there is a possibility of, tell them now. Be prepared. Are you following? That is what we are going to convey in the form of what? So potential reduction in EPS. Now we know that basic EPS equal to pace divided by waves. Now if I want reduction to happen in my EPS, there could be two reasons. Either because of my profit decreasing or waves increasing. So we are not going to consider anything about profit factor. We are not going to discuss any change in profits. We are going to assume the same profit of this year only with the profit of next year. I am not going to budget the profit of next year. I am not projecting the profit of, I am telling same profit of current year. Even if this profit earned in the next year, our EPS will, because increase in, because increase in number of shares, waves. Karatapa, please respond.
Yes,
and that too without increase in resources. Future increase in, please respond. Last one. Number of shares without, which means in future I am going to issue shares, I am going to get cash, that I am not going to consider. Because if I get cash, I will get more employment in the future, I will get more profit. Are we going to assume different profit or same profit?
Same profit.
Same profit. So in that case, same resources. Even if same resources there, number of shares will? Not bonus. There is no concept of future bonus. Bonus means already over. What and all? Now, there are three instruments, friends. Convertible debentures. Convertible preference shares. Options. What are the three instruments which will increase shares? Convertible debenture. Convertible preference shares, option. Like that, there are three instruments which cause dash, dilution. Which cause dilution. Are you following? Why do you say it is increase in number of shares without increase in resources? Because first I issue debenture in 1 year. Respond. I will get cash 50 lakhs, debenture 50 lakhs. Imagine after 5 years, after
5 years,
this debenture will be converted into shares.
Yes, sir.
Number of shares? Resource increased? Same 50 lakhs only. So that is what I am telling. The number of shares increases without increase in resources. So what this diluted EPS means? It refers to the potential Reduction in basic EPS. Simply EPS only, basic EPS arising from prospective increase in veins. This is very important. Not all future increase I am going to take, but without increase in, there are three instruments only. What and all? Convertible debentures, convertible preference share. Are we going to take future profit or current year profit? Current year profit. I am not going to project the future profit. I don't know. Everybody. But I will make some changes to the profit, because if the debentures are converted into shares, then the interest is getting saved. So that interest now becomes money available to shareholders. I am taking current year profit only, my dear friend. But whatever interest that you have paid in this current year, and sir, will get saved, will be added to shareholders. Are you following? Similarly, if you convert preference shares into equity shares, then preference dividend will be saved. In the current year EPS, you reduce preference dividend. Next year, you need not reduce preference dividend, because the preference share no longer will be preference share. They will become equity share. Correct? Appo basic earnings. What is that?
Basic.
Which means that profit that was considered for computation of, that was considered for basic EPS. Respond ba. Plus interest, dividend, tax, etc. Depending upon which is converted. Divided by basic veins plus. Suppose this computation resulting into anti-dilution. Suppose this computation resulting into, don't report that, simply ignore it, that's all. You will report only basic EPS. Suppose this computation resulting into, what do you mean by that, sir? Sir, this computed amount, no, happening to be more than basic EPS. How is that possible? It may be possible because the savings in interest is so huge that it is increasing the EPS. Are you following? All these years we are paying huge amount of interest to whom? Debenture holders. Now debenture is going to become? Now lot of interest is getting saved. Correct? But generally it may decrease, but sometimes in, if it is increases now, then simply ignore it. Compute it, ignore it, don't report it. Report only dash EPS. So dilutive EPS will be reported only if it is reducing. It is a amount which is less than basic EPS. What sort of information is that? It is a information to the readers that this reduction is the future. Are you following? Or this could be a possible reduction in future. Possible, I don't know actually. Are you following? I am not telling this is the profit in the next year. I am telling even if this same profit earned in the EPS will reduce. Please respond, friends. So how to compute diluted EPS? Basic earnings plus savings in interest. Whatever interest that you paid, no? Respond. That will be saved. But the moment you save interest, my dear friend, you should pay tax to the government. Thereby, the savings in interest is only net of tax. Savings in should be net of tax. Suppose interest saved 3 lakhs. Interest saved 3 lakhs. Tax rate 30%. What I should add? 2,10,000. In FM you would have learned that. 3 lakhs into 70%, 1 minus tax rate. If interest saved, suddenly you have to pay tax to the government. What is retained by the company for shareholders is only 2,10,000. Once again, basic earnings plus savings in interest net of tax divided by basic wages plus prospective wages. Correct? Respond. Just one problem, 2 minutes problem, I will solve. Correct? Dividend is related to preference capital. Savings in preference dividend and not net of tax, it is plus dividend distribution tax. Correct? So let us now solve just 2 minutes problem, and I will ask sir to start at 150, okay? Question number 8. Find out diluted earnings per share from the following. Net profit for current year rupees 1 crore. Number of equity shares outstanding throughout the year rupees 50 lakhs. 12% convertible debentures of rupees 100 lakhs of 100 each. Each debenture is convertible into 10 shares. Income tax rate 30%. Find out basic EPS, diluted EPS. Taken over. Now listen, friends. First, shall we? Basic EPS. அதுக்கு first basic earnings. Which is given. I have told you that if nothing is mentioned, the profit is to be understood as what? Profit after tax, but before any appropriation, before the payment of dividend. Correct, Appa? Respond. So here profit is given, no. How much given, Pa? 1 crore. So 100 lakhs. If I'm taking in lakhs, it is 100 lakhs. Everybody, now, basic wins given. Please look into the question, friends. 50 lakhs. Basic EPS, friends, rupees A by B, rupees 2. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now it is dilutive EPS. No time. 1.81. Super. We want dilutive earnings. அதுக்கு ஃபஸ்ட்டு பேசிக் ஏர்னிங்ஸ். வாட் இஸ் பேசிக் ஏர்னிங்ஸ்? 100 லேக்ஸ் ப்ளஸ் சேவிங்ஸ் இன் வாட்பா? சேவிங்ஸ் இன் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட், விச் இஸ் நெட் ஆஃப் டேக்ஸ். வாட் இஸ் த சேவிங்ஸ் இன் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட்னா 100 லேக்ஸ் இஸ் த டிபென்ச்சர்பா. Into 12% is the interest which I was paying all these years. This I can save. If I save this much now, out of the savings, I should pay 30% to government as tax. So thereby, what is real saving now? Only 70%. 8.4 lakhs. 8,40,000. Correct, Appa? So thereby, 108.4 lakhs. Everybody? Then we have dilutive veins. For the basic veins, 50 lakhs respond, plus prospective veins. Prospective veins, how to compute prospective veins? It is prospective veins is 100 lakhs divided by rupees 100. Everybody, 100 lakhs the total debenture, friends. Divide by 100, now you will get number of debenture. Each debenture is convertible into 10 equity shares. So it is totally 60 lakhs. Everybody? Then dilutive EPS A by B equal to 1.81. 2 rupees and 1.181 is answer. Impact of dilution means difference. Impact of dilution means 2 minus 1.81 equal to 0.19. Same lines la you will try question number 9 and 10, friends. Exactly ditto same pa. So you will try question number 9 and question number 10.